of groups and with a lot of different players. Started out with Bill Monroe, played with the Dillards, played with California. He played with the LA Fiddle Band, Sundance. Too many groups to actually list them all. But one of the things that happened along the way when he was back just graduating from college was Uncle Sam came knocking at his door and said, it's your turn to join the Army. And it just so happens, by coincidence, that one of our strongest and earnest, most helpful members, Fred Robbins, was in that same place down in Louisiana. And Fred is here tonight, and I can give Fred the microphone and say a few words about meeting Byron back in the Army.
I'll try to keep it short so these great musicians can get started. It was pure luck in my bluegrass journey. I've gotten really lucky a lot of times. This was one of the most lucky. It was 1969, and I'm at Fort Polk, Louisiana, hot day. I'm on my break, and I'm driving along the road and the base, and I hear bluegrass. And I literally whipped into this parking lot of a movie theater, and there's 500 GIs sitting on the ground. I nearly killed them. They went scattering. I heard bluegrass. There's a band up there called the Cumberlands with a banjo player named Jim Smoke and this guy, Byron Burline. I knew who he was, ran back to my quarters, got my copy of the Dillard's Pickin' and Fiddle, an album that I had, got up to him, Byron, afterwards. Mr. Burline, will you sign this? Turns out he was stationed there. He found out I was stationed there. We were both in civvies. He still teases me to this day. He was a private and I was a lieutenant. He called me on the phone the other day and said, is this Lieutenant Robbins? He would take me out to his house off base and his wife would fix me dinner, so forth. Within a few months, I was getting ready to head to Vietnam. He headed to California to play with Dillard in the expedition. When I got back from Vietnam, 2 days later, went to meet Byron in LA. We celebrated, I'll say. Ended up at Roger Bush's house the next day at Las Vegas, where Dillard and the expedition performed with K-Star at the Fremont. Later in 72, I think I would come back to visit him in LA for a week, as I told somebody earlier, drink his beer and copy his tapes. I would meet him in New York City when Country Gazette was visiting. In 1973, my friend and his Cessna, we flew down to the Culpeper Warrington Festival, and the entire Country Gazette met us at the airport, let us sleep on the hotel floor. So I've had that kind of luck and met people like Alan Mundy, Doug Dillard, Roger Bush, and all the names I could possibly drop. I'm so thankful for them putting me up that many times, so I'm getting even, I mean reciprocating tonight by having him come here. When I say having him come here, I gotta say that all I did was make one email message when Lynn Lipton had asked me, it'd be really nice to have Byron come here. After that, Lynn and Mike Foley did all the arrangements, the ticketing and so forth. We've got the crew here tonight that's handling the rest and the refreshments and these great musicians behind us. So one email address, and all I can do now is thank them all for this, because I'm gonna sit back and watch Byron Burline and Gold Rush.
I'll never forget that. You know, I guess I was a spec four by that time, just above private. So, you know, give me a little credit, you know.
Who cares?
Anyway, good to see you, Fred. Good to see all you guys out here tonight, too. And we're going to do some bluegrass. Is that okay?
Yeah.
We'll start off a little tune that I recorded with Bill Monroe. And it's called the Gold Rush.
Thank you.
just another lonesome day. And I know you want me far away. This is a neat church, isn't it? Isn't this beautiful? I really like this church. Yes, it feels good to play music in here.
Yeah.
And we just met in the parking lot.
What time is it now?
I know it. And I'm sure I'll get all their last names messed up, but this is Jen.
Yep.
Jen. And Keith. And Mike. And they're all really good at what they do. I can testify to that. Let's all testify, folks.
I'm feeling it.
Yeah.
Now, we have stuff scribbled down here on a piece of paper that just kind of gives us an idea of what to do, but.
I think we had a band request for Maiden's Prayer.
You all gonna dance? Do you dance in this church at all? Or do they allow you to dance? Oh, there's your part. Well, this is Bob Wills. When I play a Bob Wills music, everybody just jumps up out on the dance floor and starts dancing. So, if you feel like it, go ahead. I don't think it's not a sin, is it? Unless you're a Baptist.
Not a real time.
Right.
Thank you.
Jen, you live in New York City, don't
you? I certainly do.
Brooklyn,
yeah, I came all the way from Brooklyn to be here today. I'm just honored, delighted, thrilled. Happy to see everyone.
Yeah.
Happy to be here.
Well, I'm happy to be here too.
Great.
Whose turn is it? Your turn?
Is it my turn? I could sing one, and then maybe Keith could be on deck for the next one. Okay, we're going to do a little bit of the Blue Ridge Cabin Home. Yidgy.
Song right now. It's a Bill Gross song. Actually, one of the first songs I ever learned. My father made me learn to play and sing. It's the only song I know. But.
It is not.
It's a good one. And it's called My Rose of Old Kentucky.
This is a lot of people's favorites.
Right here.
Nice hand for Jerry Olin over here.
Another Bill Monroe tune. We always refer this to as the number one bluegrass instrumental. It's called the Bluegrass Breakdown.
A pre-Foggy Mountain Breakdown song. Thank you.
conditioning on for a minute?
Okay. All right, we're going to slow it down a little bit with another iconic Bill Monroe song, one of my favorites. A lot of wonderful bands and singers have recorded this one over the years. I think this might have been the first, if I'm not mistaken about my Monroe history, this might have been the first song that he wrote that had words to it. Simple yet very effective, I think. Well done, Mr. Monroe. It's going to be the Kentucky Waltz.
All right.
And for anybody who'd like to dance, yeah. I think that Jody and Lynn have paved the way, so.
How does this go?
Yeah.
Oh, you want me to start it?
Yeah.
I'd love that.
Good job.
Beautiful Kentucky.
Yeah, this is turning Mike loose over here on the mandolin. He's quite a mandolin player. And he told me he knew Old Dangerfield, and this is a kind of a song that probably not too many people heard of, but it turned out to be a really good instrumental that Bill Monroe put together a few years ago. Named it after one of his hound dogs. I don't know whether you know that or not. Come on, Old Dangerfield, come on now. Get up. Come on. Old Dangerfield.
It's always about dogs.
Those dogs will never come to you when you want them to. You know? Anyway. He wrote a good instrumental anyway.
this, though. We haven't rehearsed anything. I just got back from just a whole week. I did a fiddle workshop, fiddle camp that Mark O'Connor does. He does one in Tennessee, and then he does one in New York City. And this, I was just there to that big soiree of all these great players show up and teach these, well, all ages, actually, a lot of kids there, though. And a lot of them are beginners. But anyway, a lot of really good players. But I'd like to ask a question. How many fiddlers do we have in the audience tonight? Anybody play the fiddle? How many would like to learn to play? Anybody out there like to learn to play the fiddle? Same ones. Well, this is a, I'm going to do a little song to explain to you how easy it is to play the fiddle. And I guarantee you go home, get your grandmother's or grandfather's fiddle, wherever it's hid, on the bed or in the closet. Get it out, tune it up, and you'll be able to play equally well as I do on this next song. I guarantee you. Yeah. This is in the key of G, ladies and gentlemen.
Yeah, we were having a meeting over here trying to figure it out. So.
This is called Fiddle Faddle. And I'm going to sing it so I can show you how easy it is to play the fiddle. You didn't hear that. So here we go. In the beginning. Nothing to know. You push on the strings with your left hand. Your right one is left for the bow. You can play an easy song or a hard one. The melody is easy to get. If it's sharp, flat, or scruggs, don't you worry. Well, move your fingers just a little bit. With the bow on the strings, you pull or you push. Your face is contorted in a frown. Your left hand will find all the notes that you need. It either goes up or goes down like this. Summer at Mark's camp. Well, you try and try a lot, nothing happens. The time that you practice seems long. If a squeaky, squawky sound you're still getting like that, well, do again, you're doing something wrong. With the bow on the strings, you pull or you push. Your face is contorted in a frown. Thank you.
Fade in the key G for you instrumentalists out there, musicians. You want to follow along? All right, we're going to be doing Today Has Been a Lonesome Day.
Has a key.
Well, with four kids, you know. Yep.
Song and then take a break, because I know there's a bunch of dessert over there that you're just mouth-watering for, and there's a lot of t-shirts I see that can be purchased. It is summertime, it's just t-shirt weather. You can wear those all the rest of summer, and even in the wintertime, you put them on underneath your shirt, you see how great a deal that is. And I brought some CDs, about five or six of them is all I have left. But they're over there, I think. And I want to tell you about I helped get started, a bluegrass festival in Guthrie, Oklahoma. It's called the Oklahoma International Bluegrass Festival. We have groups from all over the world to come in there and play bluegrass. I have a brochure there that tells all who's going to be there. And some really good groups. But we have all kinds of music there. Mainly 90% of it's bluegrass, but so we have other kind of different kinds of music. We have some old-timey bands, and we got some cowboy singers, and then we might have a somebody like Vince Gill or Emmy Lou Harris, but this year we have Larry Gatlin going to come and sing.
Woo!
And so all these friends of mine that I've known in the past will come and help. Waylon Nelson didn't come one year. It has some kind of grass there. I don't know what it was. Anyway, I think it was blue, but it was, I don't know. But give a hand to this fine band right here. These guys are great players, aren't they? Singers. So we'll do this and then take a break, you know, and come out and say hello, and then we'll come back and play some more for you. All right? We're going to do a tune that I recorded with Bill Monroe in 1967. With Sally Gooden, and then I recorded again with him on one of my CDs called Fiddlin' Song, and along with Earl Scruggs. And that was 1994. We did that. And anyway, I like this old tune. Sally Gooden, Cuvée.